Dear students, this is the second problem we are going to solve related to rotational motion of rigid bodies. A teenager starts her bicycle by pedaling. The rear wheel spins from rest to a final angular velocity of 250 rpm in 5 seconds. Calculate the angular acceleration in radian per second square. If she now slams on the brakes, causing an angular acceleration of -87.3 radian per second square, how long does it take the wheel to stop? In the problem, the data given are initial angular velocity of the rear wheel omega naught is 0 because it is given that the rear wheel spins from rest. Final angular velocity of the rear wheel omega is given as 250 rpm. To substitute this value in the equations of motion, we have to have this value with SI unit. So to convert this into radian per second, this is 250 revolutions per minute. To have one revolution, the angle turned by the wheel should be 2 pi radian. So 250 into 2 pi radian, that is one revolution, divided by 1 minute is 60 seconds. Okay. So the final angular velocity of the rear wheel omega will be 26.18 radian per second. Okay. The motion of the rear wheel is considered after time t is equal to 5 seconds. We need to calculate the angular acceleration of the rear wheel in radian per second square. In the second subdivision, it is asked to calculate the time taken by the rear wheel to come to the rest position after applying brake with a constant negative acceleration of -87.3 radian per second square. We can use these set of equations of rotational motion. To calculate the angular acceleration of the wheel, we can use the first equation of rotational motion, that is omega is equal to omega naught plus alpha t. At the second state, the angular velocity omega is given as 26.18 radian per second. The initial angular velocity of the rear wheel is given as 0 in the problem because the motion of the rear wheel is considered from the rest position plus alpha into the time taken by the wheel to reach the angular velocity of 26.18 radian per second as 5 seconds. So from which we can calculate the value of angular acceleration alpha as 5.236 radian per second square. The motion of the rear wheel has been considered from the rest position to reach the angular velocity omega of 26.18 radian per second in 5 seconds. In the second subdivision of the problem, it is given that brake is applied at this instant by imparting a negative acceleration of -87.3 radian per second square until the wheel come to the rest position. At the final state of the wheel, the final angular velocity of the wheel will be 0. So, for the second subdivision, the initial angular velocity omega naught is 26.18 radian per second. We can use the first equation of rotational motion, that is omega is equal to omega naught plus alpha t. For the second subdivision, the final angular velocity will be 0 and the initial angular velocity omega naught is 26.18 radian per second plus alpha is -87.3 radian per second square into t. So the time taken by the wheel to come to rest position will be 0.30 seconds.